2650. Okay, well, maybe 2700. It's a nice round number, 2650. A little bit sad to move away from that number. But we're trying to think about how to. I'm trying to think about how to sacrifice already. And Mary, it has to be G4. I think G4 is going to be the theme, right? G4 and sacrifice. Can we double? Okay, I'm being inspired by Manuel Bosboom here, Mary. You just saw the tweet, didn't you? That I did. I've been reading a very interesting book, and I think it's, what's it called? Chess Buccaneer. And it's a book on a friend of mine who is a player from Amsterdam, and he's a very interesting player, Manuel Bosboom. Massive fan of the way he plays chess. He's absolutely mental. If anyone thought I was a crazy chess player, this guy takes it to another level. And it's called Chess Buccaneer, and I love the way he plays chess, and I've been enjoying his book greatly. Jobius, of course, knows him, being from Holland as well. And Jobius, I think I even found a picture of us two and Manuel together in Amsterdam, actually. Okay, so my opponent is playing quickly. Am I okay? I'm trying to work out what the hell's going on here. I was trying to, first of all, count the pawns, but I don't know why I'm trying to count the pawns. But okay, let's take that one, shall we? Why not? And suddenly it's gone a little bit materialistic. I gave up this pawn early on, and now it's gone a little bit random. But I think what we're going to try to do in the first five games, we're going to try to sacrifice for G4 or G5. That's the idea. Can I play Budapest? Does this work? What if I just take this one? He's going to take here, and then Queen A4. Looks a little bit scary, but I don't believe it really. But it looks a bit scary. Rook B8 coming. I'm not going to allow. Am I going to allow it? I'm not gonna. Do we go? Okay, I'm not going to allow it. I'm not going to let him get this sacrifice as such. He really wants to sacrifice. Okay. And now I will. Okay, we can't. We've got to take some things in life, haven't we? And I need to just stop him coming down here. I'm not a great fan of defending. But a rook is a rook, people. A rook is a damn rook. And if it was long play chess, then I would have thought that Black's attack is just nonsense. But it's not. It's blitz chess, and anything can happen. And having the initiative in blitz chess is probably a lot more important than anything else. So I'm just going to try to get my pieces around to help protecting my king. Hence why I put my rook on g2 there. And my king seems to be. He can't move his queen anywhere. Unbelievable. Oh, he's got this square. For a second there, I was like, where does he move his queen? And now that we're material up, the most sensible thing to try and do would be to swap pieces off. Can I even take that one? He takes. Let's not give the material back. And it's funny. He's actually keeping the pressure up against my position. With these threats that keep coming. But of course, this should be a winning structure, but you have to be careful in chess, don't you? This is one thing I've realized. It ain't an easy game. And like I mentioned, this is a whole rook. So I do like having an extra rook. But my king is a little bit dodge. Okay, should we push? What do we do here? I don't know about my last move. My last move seems a bit funny. Now this one also opens his bishop up, but I'm covering all those squares. Probably the real way I could lose this game is on time. So I'm going to try to avoid doing that. I don't mind if he starts making exchanges, but am I doing next? Bishop e5, take here. Still looking okay for me. Bishop e5 is nice, especially if he gets if he moves his bishop to this square. Oh, he's making exchanges. Well, I'm happy to see that, I feel. Time, Simon. Why are you so slow? Okay. Why am I doing this? I see my time tick and I'm like, ugh. But we've got to keep our cool. And I think we've done that. And now these guys are coming off as straightforward. Because, well, it's not so straightforward after that move, but. God, he's quick, isn't he? God, he. Okay, shit. Whoa! Oh man. Well, I won. Sunday, Monday, happy days. That's not like me to win the first game of the day. Very unlike me to win the first game of the day. Totally smooth. Nothing to report there. What was our opening now? Let's just have a look at the opening. So, the aim of the first five games today is to gambit, hopefully, the G pawn. We're going to try to give up our G pawn as quickly, well, not as quickly as possible, but in the first 10 moves. And this is this a novelty? We will have to have a look later. So, who else is in the chat? Hello to anyone else who's just popped along. Mike Cocker, hello. Hello, Catherine. I'm doing grand, thank you. I'm doing great. Just a little stream. We're playing a bit of chess. Hope you're doing well as well. I've been chatting to the cast of the in Oslo, and it looks like I'll be coming back for the Champions Tour. So that'll be cool. Looking forward to getting back over there. Hope you're doing all right. Blundermoth, Nom, Fishhead, Dirty Boy. Well, I don't know if that game was that dirty. Was it that dirty? I was kind of winning for most of it. You know, I won on time at the end, but it's blitz chess. What you want in life, you know? You gotta win on time. He's making it up as he goes along. I that's what I normally do in life. Isn't that what everyone does in life? They make it up as they go along. And now I'm playing the 28-33, and I've got a gambit with this move. Why? I might do a different gambit in this one, because you okay, let's see if I can get out of this. Now, you did ask me for the Budapest. So I'm gonna go for the Buda. And we're gonna go not Budapest. Why? Let's go for this one, which is the gambit I can never pronounce. What is this one? Type it. I can't pronounce this one. It's a ridiculous name. The gambit. It's not the Budapest when you put the knight here, funnily enough. It's got another name, which I can't pronounce yet. It's a ridiculously long name. And my opponent doesn't want to accept my pawn. So we couldn't really get a g5 gambit in here. It was a little bit too much there. But we can. I don't want to take the pawn back because he's desperate for me to take the pawn back. So here, I'm gonna have to now. He doesn't want any gambits going on. And let's do this one maybe. Just tack that pawn in a very weird manner. And I'm thinking that the bishop could be quite nice on f6 now. But he's coming in here as well, which is frustrating. He's got the two bishops, maybe some small advantage. He's gone that way. That's interesting to see. But yeah, this is a little bit tricky. What do we do here, people? What do we do? This one is most annoying. Do we have to? Don't like it. Okay, well, I'm just gonna try and we have to try to do something against his king, but the reason I don't like this, he's got many ways he can, as he's doing now, force my pieces backwards with his pawns. And I really have to keep this bishop because this one is too strong. He's got his two bishops looking towards me, and it's not entirely. I'm not entirely happy. That's it. The Fáborodovich variation. That is correct. Thank you there. Glad you're doing well, Catherine. Good to hear. And yeah, I should be coming over in February. And then hopefully a bit more as the events go on. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Do love Oslo. It's gonna be quite hard work though. I think the games start a bit later, so might have to be a bit careful. No, I won't be careful. Still got to get the odd beer in. Okay, so this is the crafty idea. Can I sneak? Oh, that's a real unique way to hassle my king. And I don't want to play this move because my dark squares are so bad. But what else can I do? This was a nasty idea. Yeah, how do you say it? A Fajarovic variation. Oslo gonna cost an arm and a leg. Well, fortunately, I'm working there, which means that hopefully I don't lose money, because the definition of work is, you don't pay to go to work. That would be a really shit job, wouldn't it? Oh yeah, I'm getting a new job. I have to pay them. So hopefully as I'm working, yeah, in the day, I'm joking, but of course, so it'll be. I mean, the commentary for the Champions Tour is very tough, but it's going to be very exciting to be over there. And Oslo is an expensive place, but it's a really nice place. Very nice people, and it's a good place. Just like lots of nice places to go. I love the scooters. I love scooters. I'm like the biggest scooter fan in the world. And am I getting checkmated here? What do you guys reckon? I think there's a good possibility I might get checkmated here. But I can't read. Oh, I can't. Can I take that? No. Yeah, we do take that one. And his bishops are so strong, right? What are we going to do against these bishops? I don't like it. Oh, we're going to have to try to get our rook over to defend. If I can get two moves in, get rid of these bishops, like move the rook over, exchange off the bishops, I might be okay. So I'm going to get this rook over, but now I can't easily exchange this off. My queen is extremely weirdly placed, so let's put it there. That wasn't a very good square I put it on, was it? Yeah, my position was uncomfortable there. Basically, uncomfortable. That okay. Let's see if we can. Are we playing this guy again? Okay. So we did say we're going to keep trying to get the g4 gambit in. So let's work out how we can do this. Well, that is the natural way. This is the well, I call it the Kilkenny gambit, but I think it's got some other names. He doesn't want it. He doesn't want my pawn. Have my pawn. He doesn't want my pawn. Oh, please take my pawn. Yeah, here in Norway, they most places were shut for ages. Obviously, oh, okay, so he has taken my pawn. You know, the funny thing was, I didn't realize he could take my pawn there. So this is the third game of my gambits, and I'm not sure how successful this one will be. Is it worth not having a G pawn so you've got the G file to attack? So I heard things are opening up in Norway again, which is really good because you've got to have places to go, which is great, and hopefully this COVID thing will go away soon as well. I mean, by the looks of the Omricon, I'm not a scientist, I don't know anything, but by looks of it, the Omricon is not necessarily a terrible thing. But again, someone better qualified for me could probably say I caught it and it was okay with me, but it does seem a little bit of a matter of luck as well. Okay, right, anyway, back to the game. I've got to concentrate. This guy's good. He's like 28 36 and I've given up a G pawn and I'm now got to go queen here. I wish I had a pawn on G2 now to guard my knight. This doesn't look very fun with the knight coming in. All right. Where is my compensation? Okay, I have to take that one, I think. And I hope that I don't get checkmated here. So here comes the G file. Here it comes. So this is probably not going to end well for me, and I don't really have enough pieces to do a successful attack, but you never know. If we can get the queen over, I'm a very optimistic person, extremely optimistic, maybe a little bit too optimistic. Hello, Anna. Thank you so much for the ginormous raid there. And I apologize to all your viewers from going from beautiful Anna to this ginger. So sorry about that, people, but thank you very much for the raid. It's very, very kind of you. And hello to everyone who's come over. And you've come to watch me try and play chess. Badly at the moment, and see how I get on. I'm trying to gambit, so I'm trying to sacrifice, but there's a fine line between sacrificing and losing all your pieces, and I'm not sure I've quite found the right level yet. I'm very good at losing pieces. I'm not so good at sacrificing, but we're just trying to checkmate our opponent each game. That's what it's about. I hear the aim of chess is checkmate. But thank you, that's a very kind raid. Thank you for the viewers, and hello to everyone who's come along. And I'm just playing 3 minute chess, and this guy's pretty decent, pretty handy, 28-36 rating, and I'm trying to make a way through to g7, but g7 is very well defended. The queen is defending that one. I wanted to get, and what else can we do? Can we try to get this rook over? But then d4 is going to be very weak. I'd like to get the knight in, but then he takes my knight. So he's stopping all of my ideas at the moment. So the next thing I'm thinking, can I get this one around? Okay, I don't want to open up the center because his d-file would be useful, but it's a tough position for me. So we're going to try and get the rook here, keep the pieces lined up over there, and see if something turns up. But another good move from my opponent, creating some counterplay here. Well, I say counterplay, he's quite a lot of material up. And we've got to try to get our king back to safety. Ideally, if I get the king to h1 and rook to g1, I mean, you've got a dream. The impossible dream. And then we sacrifice here. He's trying to get the queens off. We can't allow that. How many pawns down am I? Well, there goes another one. There goes another one. They're all dropping. And it's a good thing I can't count very well, because it just gets depressing when you're losing all your material like this. And I think this is, I've got to stop that check, otherwise bad news anyway. Only chance is to do a little bit of blitzing, but I'm notoriously slow at my blitzing as well. Is there anything I'm good at? Oh, look at that. That's just clever. That is really clever. You're not allowed to do clever moves. And now queen takes here is a very clever move. This is nice. Nice tactics from my opponent. And he's going to be too much material up. We'll try playing this guy one more time. I might even have to not sacrifice against this chap, because he is taking my pawns and doing damage to me. So I'm going to go back and try out my favorite opening, which is the Dutch. And we're going to stick to what I normally play, which is this line of the Dutch, where you put the pawn here. It's called the classical Dutch. And I had this position against Grandmaster Ivan Sokolov. And I managed to win that game a long time ago in Reykjavik. And you're normally in this opening doing absolutely fine from the black side when you got these pawn pushes in. And I would have figured that that's the case here. I'm just getting my king out of the rather susceptible line here. And I'm wondering if I should be pushing the pawn forwards to attack the knight or not. And I'm still tempted to do that. This knight is very annoying, actually. Or do we even play g5? Okay, let's put the bishop on this square. And I often play g5 in these types of positions. Now, let's continue with this idea And the structure I try to go to is putting these pawns on these two squares. So let's see if I can get that in. My opponent's played probably the most thematic idea, but if you've watched my streams before, hello Andy, hope you're doing all right. Haven't seen you for a long time. Hey, hope you're doing all right. Andy's got one of the biggest Minecraft channels on YouTube, so well worth checking out. And I'm probably doing quite well in this position now. This is a good chance for me against this good player. And this is, like I mentioned, the structure I go for. And if you've seen me play Blitz before, you've seen me get this position many times before. And the point is, you're trying to kill this bishop and gain space. So this bishop can't get out. And the way that white normally gets the bishop out is by playing f3, which he can't play now. Now, he'd probably want to get his bishop to f1, try to move this knight to the lovely f4 square, but that's going to take him some time. So the next thing that you often do in this structure is his pawns are on light squares, and this idea of playing a5, a4 is a great way to attack those ones. Horsey makes L shape. It's funny what you learn, isn't it? They do make an L shape. So this is a maneuver, again, which I expect my opponent will be trying to do. And I'm wondering now if I actually come in here. This is a very, I don't know if I should be playing this move or not. The idea is, if he takes with a bishop, I take with a pawn, and can that knight ever get back in the game? Now, which way do I capture, the g pawn or the e pawn? Does it make any difference? G pawn, maybe? I don't know. I don't know which is the correct way. And this is the move that I'm relying on to stop any intrusion points in my position. And look at that knight. This is what I'm trying to play against. The knight can't at the moment get in the game. My king can centralize. I can activate my rook on this a file. So my opponent is trying to find a way to do some stuff here. And this makes a lot of sense, but if he does play here, I'm probably going to grab the pawn. But I'm going to keep improving my position by centralizing. I probably play h5 to cut down on this. And now this is the move my opponent wants to play, but does. Okay. So this is a tremendous position, but I can, of course, mess it up. Now, king g5 is not stupid to stop g4 from being an option because I take the knight. I'm fixing that pawn on a light square now because I have a light square bishop. So I want to use my light square bishop to eventually capture that pawn. My opponent's rook can't get in on any of these squares. And how are we going to win this? I might have to go here to try and win, allowing my opponent's rook to come around the back. But if I can, I think it is just winning. So that was actually what I would say is a good game. I rarely play a good game of chess. Smooth. Oh yeah, baby. Smooth game. And my opponent resigned because basically I'm just going to go rook a4, attacking c4. And then my bishop will take this pawn, and the a pawn will queen. There's nothing that white can do. The only chance is that when I go rook a4, my opponent moves the rook to d8, but that's not going to help. And you look at the knight can't move. And that game was kind of trying to work out how to stop my opponent's plans whilst improving my position. So g4, I take the knight. The knight can't move, the pawn can't move, the king can't do anything. The rook has nowhere good to go. So I've just got to threaten these light squares. Just play good moves. That's what it's all about, Mary. That is what it's all about. I'm not always good at that, but it's, you know, occasionally I can, you know, what's it, even a blind squirrel finds the odd nut. My opponent, this is actually very peculiar. My opponent, extremely kind. Do you know what my opponent said in the chat, which is very surprising? Look at this. Great game, have to go. Normally when I lose a game, I'm like, you bastard, So that was very nice of my opponent to say so. Thank you for the donation there.
Woohoo!
We have a donator. Shock. Thank you very much. And going back to the chat, hello to Marpants. Haven't seen you for a while,
Oxana,
Marpants.
World I'm really sorry
Marpants.
For it.
Do I have to call you world champion now, Marpants? I think I do, for your brilliant amateur world champion. Brilliant result. Well done. Anyone who's new has come along. Great to see you. And I think we should just get to 2700 now, right? After that game, 2700 must be the place we're going, right? Thank you for anyone. I'll call you world champion from now on then, shall I, Marpants? Only world champion. There's not many people who call themselves a world champion, so good stuff. And by the way, thank you to anyone who has subscribed to the channel as well. Now, I play this little line against my opponent's opening, and I always forget what I'm supposed to do in this particular position. This is actually, weirdly enough, some theory. But what do I do? What do I normally play here? I think I give the pawn back to try and restrict this bishop, but it's a bit bad when you can't remember your own openings. Maybe have to check this one on G-Chess later. Like I say, hello to anyone else who's joined the stream. It's good to have you come on. We're trying to get to 2700 one of these days. One of these days. Will we do it today? Who knows? I'm going to sensibly develop my pieces in this game. I'm going to sensibly get my king shuffled over, get it castled. I know, I've changed my mind about sacrificing the G-pawn, haven't I? I do feel a little bit guilty. I started this stream saying I'm going to sacrifice... Should we give him a little check? Why not? Pat's the C's one. I'm going to sacrifice my G-pawn in the first five games. And I lost two games in a row. I'm like, I'm not sacrificing that G-pawn anymore. It ain't working. And my opponent is having the fun with the G-pawn. Limescale saying, roll long Hastings at the end of the year. Hopefully it takes place and hopefully I play. Well, you know what? It's the Hastings competition is probably one of my favorite tournaments. I've got a lot of favorite tournaments. Can we go here? This looks like fun. Just trying to open up the position. My knight might be able to travel to this lovely square. I love Hastings. It's not a tournament for everyone, but it's the longest ever running chess tournament in the world. Now, this move is my idea. I should also think about what I'm doing in this game occasionally, but is this move even better? Let's use Freddy, shall we? And not everyone loves Hastings because it's really miserable weather at the end of the year. It's cold, it's wet, but I like Hastings. I really like it. I don't know, maybe I just like cold, wetless pieces because it reminds me of my soul. No, that's not true. I'm a very warm chap. I'm warm enough. That's why I need cold places. So yeah, I hope to get over there. I hope to make it over there. And back to this game. So my idea is if my knight gets to that square, I am very, very happy. I could have captured a pawn there, but I'm just developing. I'm just developing the bits and bobs as we go. And do we think about this one? Maybe. May we? Hastings, that's where Hastings is also a shithole. You know what? The old town is beautiful. The old town is beautiful. It is beautiful. You are warm indeed. Well, thank you. That's very kind. And Darren, not so much of the cuddly, please. You know, not so much of the cuddly. I'm okay being warm, but you keep your cuddles to yourself, please, sir. Cuddly. I am probably quite cuddly. Who doesn't like a good cuddle now and again? Anyway, back to the chess. So I think my opponent's position... What are we talking about? What are we talking about? So I think my opponent's position is crumbling. Crumbling. Natsu, it seems like you know Hastings really well. Did you know? Okay, are we getting nearer 2700? A little bit. Did you know, Natsu, that the World Crazy Golf Championships happens in Hastings, I think, nearly every year, right? So they have the World Crazy Golf Championships. And okay, we've got a strong GM here. And did you know that the world champion is a young Russian girl? This is the last time I studied the intricacies of crazy golf. Didn't even say it right there. And the world champion, I believe, is a young Russian girl whose dad is a multi-millionaire and created a crazy golf pitch at his big mansion and employed a full-time crazy golf tutor for his daughter. Rumor has it his daughter practices crazy golf. So this is where you've got to hit the ball into Donald Duck's mouth, for example. Practiced 12 hours a day to become the undefeated crazy golf champion of the world multiple times. Now, do you think I'm making that up, or do you think I'm actually serious? That is my next question. Does it matter? Crazy golf, if you haven't played it, is like I love everyone loves crazy golf. I mean, when you go on holiday, right? You play crazy golf. Crazy golf is where what's going on in the chest? Let me just try it. Okay, let's try to get castle. That's often a good idea. Is where you literally you're on a little pitch and you have crazy things going on. Like there's like literally Donald Duck and you have to hit the ball in his mouth, or there's a bear and you have to like roll the ball in his bottom or something. It goes through his bottom and it's a hole in one. Whoa! Went through the bear's bottom. Whoa! Get in there, son. Crazy golf is much more fun than actual golf. I agree with you. I mean, I've never got into real golf, Martin. Never got into real golf. Okay, so hang a minute. Is there some tactics? Takes, takes, takes. Yeah, there's some tactics. That's not very nice. I don't like tactics. So if I get castled, I'm gonna be feeling happy. Oh, look at this. Andy is Yoda is coming out with all the facts today. Andy is Yoda, it won a Platinum Lieu of the Year awards. How did you know this, Andy? Did you just Google what is Hastings famous for? And it came up with it won the Lieu of the Year awards. How do you know these things, Andy? How do you know these things? I don't know. Pizza Racer says, Simon, I believe anything you say. You shouldn't. I'm as honest as I'm a pretty honest chap, actually. I think we might have to put the light on. We're getting a little bit of interference on the camera. It's my halo of goodliness is reflecting around. Let's put the camera on, shall we? And then we better get back to the chess. So what is happening with the chess here? Okay, well, either are the I mean this is the first little tactic I'm looking at, but there's queen to e5 here as well. Queen e5 looks like a good start. If I was castled here, I would be extremely happy, but I'm not. And my opponent could have considered playing c3 here because this is a very peculiar position. I think he has to play bishop takes d5. Maybe not, but I should be all right. Now in an ending, I should be fine. I can just shuffle the king to towards the center. So, oh no, okay. Well, that's a good move. Well, is it a good move? Oh, I have to calculate. I hate calculating. Here, and my knight's on pre. So actually, that is a good move. That is a very good move for my opponent. Do I have to defend this pawn? Which is a little bit uncomfortable. And am I going to be slightly worse than the ending here? Well, probably because I'm losing a pawn, but my king is quite active. Might be okay. Might be okay. I don't think it will be okay. A pawn is a pawn after all. And my opponent has picked up a pawn and taken the open file. So good play, as you expect. I haven't really got much I can do here. So this is going to be a very tough game. What to do in such positions? It's often a good idea to advance your pawns. because you might be able to create some targets, but this is really not a fun position to play. So I'm trying to attack something, but I'm not really getting anywhere. Can we go here and mix it up a little bit? I'm gonna try and play such a position. I'm down on time as well, just to make things that even more difficult. And I don't know what I'm doing to stop these pawns. It's not fun. Losing, I think. Okay, we can resign that one. Thought I was doing okay there, but it's my opponent found that quite nice tactic in the middle game, just to win that pawn, and then converted the extra pawn very nicely. So we're going to go back to my normal open repertoire, the Queen's Gambit. This is what I play most of the time, and this is the semi-Tarash variation, which has become quite popular. And this one is also a popular move, and this is where I can't remember what you should do. So I'm just going to take with a knight. Might have been better options, and I will give myself a weak pawn on c3 with the hope that, is this Vieri? This looks a bit like a Vienna opening. And okay, development is key. I'm not worried about this pawn, and my opponent's moving quickly, sort of, which makes me think it might be Fury. I don't really want to take there because it helps my opponent develop. Can I even go knight takes e6 here? That's a crazy idea. I think just pawn takes bishop. So let's keep thinking about this one. Let's go for bishop d3. Aiming for h7 a little bit later on. Is this gambit the Shahara gambit? It's a bit like the gambit Magnus Carlsen played the other day, but slightly different. I don't know the name of it. I don't know the name of all openings. I mean, how many openings are there? There's a bloody lot of them, right? How many openings are there? There's at least 1,500. I read. Now, can someone please type all those opening names into the chat, please? Is actually someone going to do that? I wouldn't be surprised if someone does actually try to do that. Eric Rosen knows all the gambits. He certainly does, doesn't he? Yeah. Well, let's threaten checkmate. Queen here, knight f3. I think we'll go for that one. So my opponent's giving up the exchange. He could have gone queen there, quite possibly. And this should be better for me because I do have the extra exchange, but my opponent has this strong dark square bishop. And have I just done something really stupid with my knight there? Have I literally done something completely ridiculous with that piece? Very hard to suddenly defend this. That is really stupid. Do I have to go e5 and give a very important pawn back? Maybe. I can't see any other way to. But now my opponent takes and goes e5. This is terrible stuff. What a way to throw an opening. Oh, that was appalling. And now I'm just losing. Oh, it's horrible when you just throw positions away like that. Oh, Simon. Why? My opponent should have taken with a pawn there, but it hardly matters. And I think my only hope in this position is this. But why is my opponent allowed this? I don't understand. I mean, when you're material up, you can often hurry to swap pieces off, but not when you get this kind of malarkey going on. Did someone actually try to start typing the gambits? Here they are. Dark side, message deleted. 500 character thing. Thank goodness. I really didn't want to see you type all those gambits in. Okay, so this is, funnily enough, material on material equal. But if anyone's playing for a win, it's certainly white. And my opponents, you shouldn't always move your pawns. It's sometimes bad to move your pawns. And I feel here, my opponent shouldn't have been moving the pawns on the king side the way he did. But I'm down on time as well. How am I going to try and win this? Well, I'm using my king and rook as much as possible, is the first thing I'm thinking. I'm trying to keep my rook on light squares so I never get attacked by the bishop. And again, I'm just using these guys to cramp my opponent's king as much as he can. And he doesn't really have any active play here, so this is probably just losing. Got to be careful we don't run into some tactic bishop d4, but we won't do that. We're threatened checkmate, and okay, there we go. And if he hadn't done that, I would have started picking up the pawns, and I think my opponent's position was losing anyway. So that was kind of a ridiculous game there, right? I mean, quite a good opening. Won the exchange. Lost about three pieces. It felt like three pieces in a row. And then won a piece back, and then played like Magnus Carlsen in the ending. A very bad version of Magnus Carlsen. Let's go for e4. And horsey makes L. First time you commented, but you're a sub. Thank you, horsey makes L. We get a king's gambit, and we're getting a little bit nearer 2700. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit nearer. Just a little bit. What's that really annoying pop song that I'm singing? Anyone know the annoying pop song that I'm singing? It's like, I don't know. Sometimes you get these songs stuck in your head. And, you know, these artists should be, I mean, they should be crucified for it. Wouldn't it be easier to commentate and play with a 3+2 format? It's a very sensible question by Vanilla Machito. And the answer is yes, but I don't like doing things easy. I like challenges in life. Much better to have a little challenge. Of course, it would be easier. The only thing I would say is it's a bit harder to get a game at that time limit. So that is one reason. What is this pawn formation? This is weird. That's not normal, is it? Very peculiar stuff. Where do I put this rook, people? Here? I'm thinking my knight wants to go here, my queen wants to come over here, and my other rook wants to come over here, because one thing I'm very good at is targeting my opponent's king. I don't really know how to play chess any other way except for look at the opponent's king and put all your pieces near it. So naturally, this one, oh my God, I just played that. I thought my king was on g1. That was a complete hallucination there. I was like, what? What? You muppet, Simon. You imbecile. Okay, well, oh no, this is just lost now. What was that all about? Okay, maybe he's gonna do a similar blunder and not see that that's checkmate. He can't play such a bad move, can he? Can he? Can he blunder? Can he blunder? Oh my words, that was an embarrassing blunder. He's seen it. Ah, oh, it's no fun when they find the moves. I would like to go queen e7, but my knight is a problem. That was horrendous, horrendous play by me. And how do I get the rook in the game? This is just not fun. This is not fun. What are we doing here? I don't know what I'm doing here. Anyone got any ideas? I can't see what I'm doing. Push Harry and just like. Then he goes rook here. Play rook e1. That looks so weird. This, and then he's gonna bring his rook here. Okay, maybe I have to go here, but then rook e8 just wins, right? Oh no. Oh, Simon. You had a lovely position there. Someone's shouting some tactics at me. Did I actually have some tactics there? My opponent doesn't play the most obvious win, but it's still winning. Knight e7. Damn it. Did I have something good here? What, here? Knight e7 and knight in this position? Just loses a piece, doesn't it? I feel. Okay, he's now played here. But this is not checkmate anymore, as my knight now defends this square. I'm not saying this is good. I have to give my king an escape square. And I did hear a rumour that knights were better than... Oh, he's got the queens off. We're resigned that one. So that's what happens when you blunder in chess. You lose. Okay, let's go back. I mean, my rating's just not... We started at 2650. This is the final try. We're going to give it the final push now. The final push. Let's get... Why don't I just play the Dutch in every single game I play? I should literally play this opening as white, black. Every single time I play chess, I should play the Dutch. That's what I'm thinking now. Because I like these positions. Now, I don't know. Could I have brought my queen over there? Was that another way of doing things? Probably was. And this c5, I'm not convinced I should be doing this. D5 is a bit weak with knight b3 coming. So, my c5 move was, as soon as I played it, it was like, no, why? It's a bad sign when you do that in chess. You see the bad move as soon as you play it. So what are we doing here? Well, let's maybe try to get the queen into the center. It's the only thing I can think of at the moment. But there's a lot of pressure here on my center. A lot of pressure, and I got very bad development, so this has gone wrong. C5 is just a nonsense move. Okay. I'm actually gonna probably have to stop the stream soon because we got a tree surgeon coming over. Someone who's gonna take down a tree. If you're wondering what a tree surgeon is. Well, my opponent's playing this a little bit weirdly. Okay, he has got a pawn he can take here. Let's see. What are we going to do against that? I'm going to pretend it's a sacrifice. He's called my bluff. Okay, I'm going to defend the knight and try to get in like this. Inflated job title. Yeah, tree surgeon. Well, a tree surgeon basically is someone who chops trees down. And I rent where I live at the moment, but we've got a tree that needs a chop that the landlord has applied for a chopping, and you get the tree surgeon. Yeah, it is quite a grand title, isn't it? But when someone told me tree surgeon, the first thing I thought is like, so they operate on trees. They do, but they like, I'm like thinking, what's a tree surgeon? They're like a doctor of trees. And the other one was someone told me, this is also when I'm quite a lot younger, they're like, I asked them what their job was and they're like, I'm a fencer. I do fencing. And I'm like, wow, that's really cool. You're a fencer. Meaning you like, you fight people with a sword for a living. You know, like, do-do-do, like Zorro. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Jab, jab. And I was like, man, that's really cool. So you actually, you use a sword for your living. That is such a cool job. And they're like, no, I put up fences. I'm like, all right, sorry. All right, you put up fences. That, okay, that's not really that cool, is it, actually? And they're like, no, not really. I should have known this because actually my brother's a fencer. So I should, it's probably my brother I was having the conversation with. when I was younger. It was like last week or something. So, you know, I wouldn't be that stupid nowadays, would I? All grandmasters are clever. Well, that's obviously a load of baloney. If you think that all grandmasters are clever, can I take here? Can we do this? Is this legal? I don't know. My opponent's got so many pawns. Oh, hang on a minute. I didn't see this. What's happening now? Oh, it's making me think. Why are you making me think, man? Okay. And the ending is, ooh, not fun, really. I've got to keep this pawn. Okay. Time. Got to look at the good side of life. Let's get rid of that one. Thank you. Oh, God. No. How do I miss these moves? This guy twice in a row is taking me down with two cheapos. That was definitely an off. Let's try this King's Gambit again. I think I've got a pretty good position from that. So we'll see if he does the same line again. I don't think this can be a good move, putting the knights like this. It seems like it shouldn't work because he's got to get castled, and surely that's not right. So let's try a different strategy. Let's go for c4. I don't want to go d4 because his knight might come into e3. So I'll keep defending e3. And this is something you should try and do when you play it in opening. I always say this, try to think where you can improve your opening all the time, even when you're speaking like I do. These blunders make you retardable, Simon. Oh, no, relatable. That's an easy mistake to make. Yeah, I mean, relatable maybe, but I'm not. I don't want to be relatable. I want to win every game. I'm very. I mean, it's obviously easy to blunder at blitz chess, but I've been blundering a lot recently. There is a limit to the amount of blunders one man should be making. Okay, right. Now, what am I doing here? Let's get out of this pin, and given a chance, we will try and maneuver this one around. I'm happy for exchange. I've got a nice position. I'm going to get my king out of any checks because I'm blundering so much. Safety first, and I'm just happy to play with this lovely d pawn, which will be good in some positions. So let's continue with this maneuver. F5 is a very nice square for the knight, so we will go and swing it over there if we can. Am I tempted to sacrifice on that square? Not anymore, because I can't. So we go here. I like that bishop. Don't want to exchange that. And he's going for the ending. Now, this ending is probably quite good for me with the knight coming down. I'm actually going to play this because I can kick this guy away with b4 as well. And he will have to start retreating. So, where's he going to go after this move? Because if he go, okay, he goes here. But now his knight is. Knights on the rim are dim. He can't go here because the knight there check. And g4 is an idea. Maybe knight takes h6 is an idea. Pawn takes. Rook takes f6 is something else. So I could go for this move now. Is it greedy? It's good to be greedy, isn't it? Let's grab that one. And we will now come in and take that. What next? Well, I think I want to play g4, bishop g6, take that one, take all the rooks off and be a pawn up in the ending, which I can now do. Is he going to go b5? No, I don't need to worry about that. So we want to swap off as much as we can because there's a rule about endings, and rule number one is when you're a pawn up in an ending, the easiest ending to win is just king versus king when you're a pawn up. Now, the next easiest ending apparently to win is king and knight versus king and knight when you're a pawn up. So that's like a little rule of thumb. As I'm a pawn up, we might as well go for that. And again, I'm threatening to get into a king and pawn ending, a pawn up, which should be very easy to play, but this is obviously winning now, and my opponent has resigned. Okay, that was better. That was more like it. No blundering pieces. And we've got another Dutch. I think my opponent is Dutch, actually. And this is one of the really trendy lines that White tries against the Dutch. But I think Black gets a very nice position in this kind of setup. fucking castle, and then I have one idea, the normal idea, which I'm sure if you know me, you know, get the queen over there and go for the kill. We might even try that now. Let's get the queen over there and try to checkmate. So that's rule number one. My opponent trying to, okay, well, I think we can allow this. Another good thing about moving the queen away from this square I've highlighted is that you have a very nice square for the bishop. And he's trying to swap the queens off. Now, even swapping the queens off, because I've got the bishop pair, would be all right, but I like keeping the queens on the board. Thank you, Mason's Returns, for gifting a sub to the community. Cheers. Thank you very much. Very kind of you. We need all the help we can get. And I don't want him to play g4, so we'll push Harry. Might give me ideas of continuing that. But the next thing I'd like to do here is get rid of those knights. Those knights are annoying. So I'm going to try and prepare c6 and d5. Kick both of these guys back. So that's what I'm thinking. But now that I've played this, I'm thinking, hang on a minute, he's going to go knight e3 and get rid of my light square bishop. And that actually was a very flawed plan, because I don't want to get rid of this light square bishop. I don't have a choice now. Hey ho, let's just deal with it. So we will. The thing is, when I, you know, it's the light squares which are very important in this position with his light square bishop. And by losing my light square bishop, it's a lot harder to control those squares. And well, we have to give this pawn away, but we might get very active if he does. And it's not, I don't know who's better here. It's maybe just about even, because I do have this h4 move, and if he moves the pawn, I get the f4 square, so it's not that bad. So should we go for that plan? Let's do it. Let's push this one. Can always rely on Harry. Hello, Harry. Hello, Harry. Just trying to get the f4 square if he moves g3. Now, I'm still not worried about him taking that one, because my rook will come in. Don't have to worry about that. He'll probably play it now, because then I'll start worrying about it, and I'll be like, ah, oh, well, should have worried about that one. Tell you what, I don't know if you guys are into tea, but I've been experimenting, as I say in many of my streams, with different types of tea. And can we go here now? And I'm finding that green tea is the best one for energy. Green tea, just straight up green tea. There you go, just sharing that with you there. I thought you all wanted to hear that, didn't you? You all wanted to know that, green tea. This is annoying, because he's suddenly attacking two pawns, and it's like, yeah, I'm not supposed to do that to me. So we don't want to go backwards, let's go forwards. Anyone else? Okay. Now knight here feels correct, so we, oh, my queen. That is a time to say no more. Well, it has been a day of blunders. Let me resign that one. And we went, we lost. We started on 2650. We played for about an hour. And it was a day of blunders today. Wah, wah, wah. Be better next time. How many queens did I blunder today? Jesus. I've got nothing against queens. Don't get me wrong. I really like queens. I like them, you know, I like them a lot more than you would imagine from that stream. But it's good to see you all. Make sure you do at least follow this channel, give a bit of support. And I've had enough now. That's enough for me. I'm not going to put myself through any more punishment. There were some okay games there. It was a mix. And let's just see who's online that we can give a little raid to. I think it will be over to two of the best commentators in the business. Or we could go to Lawrence Trent. That's a joke. I think Lawrence is fantastic. I like Lawrence. It's all right. You can joke about your friends. Lawrence is a very good commentator. But let's do this. So thank you everyone for watching. And maybe it's the bloody green tea. Maybe I'm just not having any more. I'm not having any more green tea now. That's enough green tea. Jesus. And I will see you all again soon for more commentary. Hopefully I won't blunder as much next time. It's been fun. And have a good day, everyone. Cheers. Goodbye.